how powerful is the King of Sweden? In reaction to my video about Swedish king's annoyance, some have asked the question, if the king, Carl XVI Gustav, was already king when the law of succession was changed in 1980, who then changed the law? Had he no power to stop the change since he didn't like it? It is also public knowledge that the king relieved his grandchildren, aside the crown princess's children, from duties incumbent on the head of state, meaning that they would not be expected to perform royal duties in future. If the king had the rights and powers to do this, why then did he not stop the change in the succession law? To what extent can the king exert his powers? How does the Swedish monarchy work? What are the duties of the king and the members of his household? Let's get this question answered, shall we? I am Ogonna Juliet Namani, and this channel is your go-to for information about Sweden and Nigeria. I also discuss great books. According to kungahuset.se, His Majesty the King has state ceremonial and official duties, which are regulated by the Swedish Constitution. It is important to note that the Swedish monarchy dates back over 1,000 years, and the role has changed in line with the rest of the society, just like the current king's motto, For Sweden with the Times. On the 1st of January 1975, a new reform gave governing power to the representatives of the people, the Riksdag. Apart from being the symbol of unity, continuity, and of course, the symbol of the country, the king promotes Swedish interest and is attentive to efforts made in and for Sweden. Specifically, His Majesty's duties include opening of parliamentary session at the request of the Speaker of Riksdag. This normally happens every September at the beginning of parliamentary working year, where the king gives speech to members of Riksdag, that is, members of the parliament. The king chairs council meetings that hold in the royal palace, for example, a change in government council, which is held when a new government comes into power. Councils of state, which is held regularly for the ministers to inform the king and the heir to the throne about the government policies. The king also chairs the Advisory Council on Foreign Affairs, which is a body of foreign policy deliberations between the government and the Riksdag. The king receives 30 to 40 newly appointed foreign ambassadors at formal audience every year. This is important because incoming ambassadors cannot formally work in a country until they have submitted their credentials to the head of state, and in Sweden, the king. These credentials are a form of authorization issued by the country's head of state. His Majesty also carries out state visits. The king represents Sweden during incoming and outgoing state visits to build relationships between countries. This is planned with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. However, unlike the British monarchy, where the monarch can appoint the Prime Minister, in Sweden, the Prime Minister is nominated by the Speaker of the Riksdag and elected by chamber by simple majority. In a nutshell, the 1974 Constitution removed the former powers of the king and rather gave such governing powers to the representative of the people called Riksdag. Hence, the king could not counter the 1980 law of succession by Riksdag despite his dislike for it. Thanks for watching.